I know, it is the Elm primary. Now, ladies and gentlemen, as this comes past, just look at the position the pilot's in. As you can see, when I said it's a seat with an aeroplane attached to the back of it, I wasn't far wrong in that description. There you go, ladies and gentlemen, he is released, he's off the tow. Maybe Bramwell, as I said, flying the Piper Cub tow, but flying the Eton has to be the most aptly named glider pilot in the history of flight. His name is Graham Saw. In its bungee launch form, your average cadet would only just about have enough time to recognise the effects the various controls were having before the aircraft would bump down safely. But thousands of air cadets and CCF cadets got their very first taste of flying in this little aeroplane, and thousands more of the Luftwaffe. You see just how exposed Graham is to the airflow. And it just to my mind, it goes to show the difference between that health and safety is made to our modern world. Because if you knew that your kid was going to join the cadet force and do something like this, would you let them? I would. I think it's a marvellous thing, I must admit. My son would love it. Of course, the modern equivalent to this aeroplane, the Grub Vigilant, used by the Air Training Corps today, an enclosed cockpit powered glider. Very much more sophisticated aeroplane. And of course, two seats side by side, not single seat. Because the other thing to remember with this aeroplane is that your first flight was also your first solo. But he has kept it up a remarkably long time. Ah, he's even giving us a big wave, ladies and gentlemen. I think when he touches down, just for sheer bravado, a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. When he touches down, just to let him know you've enjoyed this. It really is quite something. So ladies and gentlemen, totally exposed to the airflow. I'm totally at home in this little aeroplane. Mr. Graham Saw.